What's going on YouTube? This your boy B-Dot back with another video. Alright guys, I wanted to do a quick little follow-up video of my Brio Beerscape review I did a couple days ago. In that video, I showed you guys how the trimmers really lined up my beard and how I shaved down my head. Now today, I want to show you guys how I actually cut my beard, or I should say trim my beard up with the Brio Beerscape. So what I'm going to do is, as you guys know, I'm real big on Andy Slimland Pros. So I'm going to do one lineup with the Andy Slimland Pro and trim it on one side and do the Brio Beerscape on the other. So yeah, long story short, short story long, I really like the Brio Beerscapes the way they did on my head when I did my little shave down on my head. Cleaned up the neck pretty good with the Zero Gap blade that they sent me out as well. So I've already put the Zero Gap blade on here right now, as you guys can see. I will probably put the other blade on as well when it's time to fade up my beard. I like the way they handle for that as well. But in that video, I didn't show you guys how I'm going to knock down the hairs, the flyaways, and the little scragglers that you guys can see. All right, so let's go and comb through the beard real quick. Get all those hairs combed out so I can actually see what I'm doing. As you guys can see, I just put the Cut Buddy pencil on there. Not too much. I know where my line is, so just to give you guys a little visual. And, of course, I'm going to probably, like, dip into it just a little bit to make it sharp or whatever, but let's see how both of these clippers work together. So I'm gonna go first with the Brio Beerscape, and I'm probably gonna handle these on this side of the face right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut these on. Haven't used them since last time, and we're still at 162 minutes. If that thing will focus. Now, so far, so good. Now, again, I do have a coarse beard. I'm feeling a little resistance as far as like almost a snag. Like, I wish this would go up to about a 75 or an 80, if that makes any sense, to get it just that much faster. Because it feels like it's like still kind of go through the hairs. And when you got a coarse and coily beard, I felt a couple little snags just that quick. Not bad though. Definitely still can get the job done. All right, now I'm gonna stop about right here and do the other side with the Slimline Pro. And keep in mind also, guys, this is actually a clipper. It's not a trimmer like the Andy Slimland Pro. So it's a lot bigger, a little more bulkier. But the reason why I'm comparing them both together is because this is a zero blade and my Slimline Pros has a zero blade on it. So it's got wider teeth, of course, so more coverage. But this is a clipper and the Slimline Pros is a trimmer. As you guys can see right here, the difference in the blade width. It's kind of hard to compare them both, but I'm glad I got the zero blade to go with this so I can really show you guys the difference. All right, so as you guys can see, and I haven't done this part up here yet, but I just wanted to show you the actual trim part of it. Looks pretty decent right there. Nice contour to my face the way I like it. The back of the neck, nice and clean back here. You got the hair away kind of cool. Pretty decent line around the back right here as well. You know, I can rock with that one as far as that little crispiness like that. Still not a huge fan of how I was getting these really curly hairs down here underneath my neck. Sometimes I like a little sharp line down there as well. Forget it, man. Let's go ahead and knock out this side too as far as the cheek line goes since I'm already on this side. That's not bad right there, fellas. That's really not bad. I let about a week or so pass to let some more hair actually grow up there. Now that I really got it really clean, you know, it's good to go actually, you know what I'm saying? So just doing this side, that's not bad with the Brio Beardscape. And another good thing about these is these are clippers. So you got your guard attachments as well as the Andy Slim 9 got guard attachments. This is a zero blade and it also has the fade in blade where you can adjust it to do all this. So you're going to probably get more bang for your buck with the Brio because this acts as a clipper. So you can cut your hair, you can fade, you can do a lineup if you got the zero blade on here. Now, if you don't have the zero blade on here, you got to take the lineup out of the equation for a coarse beard, in my opinion. Now let's get to this other side with the Andy Slimline Pros, the B Dot favorites. These sort of act like a clipper, but you don't have any adjustable features like you have with the Brio. So if you're trying to use this as a hair cutting tool totally, whatever you don't get from the guard attachments, that's the lowest you're gonna probably get on trying to get that ball to the next level, to the next level, to the next level. You know what I'm saying? So it will work, but sometimes it's good just to have a full clipper. You guys know I rock with the Masters, Andy's Masters, with my full clippers before these. So let's continue this. You already can hear that motor. A lot faster. A faster blade movement, I should say. And to me, these with that motor speed is really a game changer to me because it really cuts through the hair and gives you that precision immediately. So you can actually see it without having to go over it time and time again. Well, you probably can't see from this angle I'm at right now, but I'll show you the results. All right. All right, so now you guys can see both sides. This is the Andy side right here, and this is the Brio Beardscape side. Pretty contour to the face. Same premise on that. Did what it's supposed to do. Less work with the Andes, in my opinion, because it cuts right through. A little faster motor, as I said. And so yeah, let's go ahead and line up the cheek line and knock all these hairs off as well. butter on the neck. Now before I hit the cheek line with them, just so you guys can see, that's a B dot neck right there, man. See how I just hit that line up over there? It fell off like butter. That motor speed was really kicking to knock those curly hairs off a little easier. Neckline, I was able to get it a little sharper down here just with a couple little strokes with the clipper, with a liner. Hair is a little bit more difficult. Maybe it's because of the bigger blade, or in my opinion, probably just the motor speed, you know? Not bad at all, definitely decent. Definitely able to step out with this side, you know, do whatever, take some pictures, ha ha, he he with the peoples. Let's knock out this cheek line real quick. Man, I know I need a haircut too, but. While we at this, let's did the mustache on this side with the Andes, the same on this side of the beard. Let's go ahead and use the Brio on this side of the mustache so you guys can see that difference. As you guys can see, Andes. Now let's do the Brio. Yeah, that's beautiful. Now the Brios hit the mustache really, really good on that one, didn't it? You guys can see, Andes, Brio. That's decent right there. So as you guys can see now, Slimline Pro side and the Brio side. I like this line over here a little bit better, a little bit sharper over here. I couldn't really get those coily hairs on my neck to really raise up with the Brios, but that's not a deal breaker to me. The back of the neck with the Brio is definitely good. In my opinion, Andes a little bit better. That's the Andes line. Still got the chalk on there, of course. And that's the Brio line. You know, so in my opinion, if you are looking for a full clipper with an adjustable blade in order for you to actually fade up your sideburns and that kind of thing, I would definitely go with the Brio Beard Skate. Of course, there's other clippers out there. If you already got the Masters and all that kind of stuff, I don't think you got to worry about these. But what gives these a little lead on those right now, in my opinion, is they do come with a zero blade. If you are buying a zero blade just to knock off your hairs easier or whatever, the Masters aren't gonna give you that really, really close shave like these will. Now, if you don't get the zero blade, you might as well just stick with the Masters or the Fast Feed or whatever clipper that you're using with the adjustable handle. I would definitely just stick with those. You know what I'm saying? As far as the liners go, Andy Slimline Pros, you guys know all the features of this. They do come with the guard attachments, which I really don't use unless I'm trying to just do something for you guys on video and show you how the attachments go. But these are great for bald in my head. And as you guys can see, great for coarse beard lineup or any lineup for that matter. But I do have a coarse beard, so I'm speaking for myself. So this is definitely my winner overall because I own the Masters Clipper. I just want to give you guys a quick video on the comparison, maybe do a little thumbnail. So I want to thank you guys for joining me today. Thanks for all the continued support. Continue to like, comment, and subscribe on the videos. And I'll holler back. Peace.